Today on Upfront, is she itching to take on Scott Walker in a recall election? Former Dane County Executive Kathleen Falk is my guest next on Upfront.
People around the state are urging me to run. You know, I was a county executive for a historic 14 years, balanced a budget every year, and brought people together to get things done.
Recall organizers are in their final days of gathering signatures to recall the governor. Next, are elections officials ready for what's coming? And Wisconsin's economy, are there better days ahead in 2012? It's all this week on Upfront.
Honest, candid, insightful. This is Upfront with Mike Gouchet.
Hello again, everyone, and welcome to Upfront. $9 million, that's the estimated cost of a recall election, a statewide election for Governor Scott Walker. We're now just 10 days away from the deadline for petitions to be filed in the recall effort targeting the governor. State Democrats are confident they'll get the 540,000 signatures they need, but they're hoping for a far higher number, perhaps 700,000. Throw in efforts to recall the lieutenant governor and four Republican state senators, and the Government Accountability Board has a monumental task ahead of it in 2012. And that job just got bigger and perhaps a bit more expensive. Last week, a Waukesha County judge said the GAB needs to do more to vet the signatures on the recall petitions. Joining us now to talk about these latest developments is Kevin Kennedy, the executive director of the Government Accountability Board. He's at our Minneapolis affiliate. Director Kennedy, thanks very much for joining us today. Let me begin by asking you to briefly explain the cost here. Why $9 million? Why so expensive?
Well, most of the costs that come in running elections are borne at the local level. The county clerks have to print ballots, program equipment, and publish notices. Municipal clerks have to hire poll workers, by far the biggest cost, train those poll workers. They need staff time to process absentee ballots. So that's the largest component of those costs. You usually don't see those costs.
State Representative Robin Voss said on Friday he thought the cost could conceivably go as high as $20 million. Is that possible?
Well, if we have two elections, it'll definitely be higher than that. That's the cost of running one election. If we have to run a primary, depending on whether it's a statewide primary or just in some of the Senate districts, you'll see those costs increase.
But ideally, your hope would be, depending on whether or not we have these elections, of course, everything could be done on one day. If there are no primaries, you would try to do everything on one day.
Well, we'll try and get all of the elections scheduled for one day, but we can't control the primaries.
Right.
That's really entirely up to who decides to make the run for the office.
I know you've had a little bit of time now to think about the judge's ruling in Waukesha County on Thursday that ordered the Government Accountability Board to do a more thorough job of vetting recall petition signatures. Now that you've had a chance to think about it a little bit, what can you do to address the judge's order?
Well, you know, the biggest challenge is to identify duplicate signatures. You know, the issue of fictitious names or illegibility, we had standards in place on that, and they have been refined as we've worked through several recalls on that. And I think we're very confident we can address the judge's concerns there. We did not want to change our standard of review just because of a particular recall unless there was a basis for doing that. And the court has basically given us that basis by saying, be more proactive. And so identifying duplicates is always a challenge. And so we're going to have to develop some software where we can actually make our best efforts to track individual names on the petition so we can match against possible duplicates.
Will it take more time to go through the signatures now that you have to pay special attention to the possibility of duplicates?
Yes, because in addition to having two sets of eyes review each line on that petition page, we're also going to have to do some data entry on that line for every line. Before, we were only going to be data entering information where we struck it so we knew the reason for it and when we were dealing with specific challenges. So now we're looking at every signature. We'll have a data entry in a database, and that costs more money, takes more time.
If it takes more time, and obviously there are concerns about cost, does it make any sense for the GAB to consider trying to do this on an election day in the middle of August when you already have a statewide primary, Republican primary for U.S. Senate? Does that make any sense? Is that a possibility?
Well, it's really a challenge to do it on that day because that's our most complicated ballot because you have separate ballots for the political parties, mm-hmm. Including our minor parties. And in addition, we'll have different districts. If we have any Senate recalls at the same time, you'll have different districts. There'll be a lot of confusion in terms of where people vote, the type of ballots that they have.
I want to go back to what happened in Waukesha County Court on Thursday. I had a viewer write me, and he said, why did it take a judge's ruling for the GAB to do its job? And I'd like to frame the question a little differently. How do you address this perception problem that Republicans have suggested that the board is unfairly taking sides in these recall elections? What do you have to say to those kinds of arguments?
Well, this isn't a question of taking sides. There are standards that have been applied to every recall petition review that's been in place. You know, we had both parties subject to recall this past spring. The standards were the same, and I think what we were trying to make sure we didn't do was change the standards because this was more high level. We wanted to make sure we treated this recall the way we did all other recalls. The point is that as we've gone through every recall, you learn more about what the process is and how to address the issues. And a lot of what's happening here are hypotheticals that have not ever come up in prior elections as well.
Mm-hmm. The Assembly Speaker, Jeff Fitzgerald, back in December, suggested that he was not thrilled with the performance of the GAB, you know that, and he suggested it might be time to do away with the agency, to go back to the way things used to be in Wisconsin. What has been your reaction to that, and do you think there is any chance whatsoever of that happening?
Well, I don't know if there's any chance on it, but it's really would be a step backwards to do that. I mean, you know, we have working, making the decisions here, former judges. These are the people that society has picked to handle these very difficult decisions. For the first time, the decision makers, as well as the staff, are required to be nonpartisan, meaning they're not making political contributions, they're not holding other public offices, they're not working as lobbyists. And I think that brings a level of credibility that you do not see in other states. I'm up here in Minnesota where, you know, the person in charge of elections is an elected partisan. That doesn't mean he can't do his job fairly, but it does raise questions on the other side. We don't have that here.
Maybe a final question. Part of the reason why I think some Republicans in particular were unhappy is a comment by a staff member from your board who you know, said, in terms of vetting signatures, well, we're not going to knock out, you know, maybe a funny name or something like that. We're checking more to see addresses, and there are other ways of catching this. In retrospect, could that have been handled differently by your board? Did that contribute to this atmosphere where some Republicans are suggesting that there is bias here?
Well, I think it may have contributed to that, and quite frankly, once that comment was made, there was a focus on what did you mean by that comment, because
yeah.
You know, we went back and looked at our standards and said that's not the way we treat these things. And we do expect you to exercise common sense when you see fictitious names. We don't expect you to extrapolate from illegible addresses on this.
So you have said that you think in some respects that might have been taken out of context?
I think it was taken out of context. I think it was blown out of proportion on this. I mean, this is a challenge you always have. Human decision-making here, and the judge recognized that, too. He said, I don't know how the GAB is going to make its decisions, but they're going to have to exercise some judgment, and that's the key. I want them to be more proactive than what they had articulated in the past.
All right. Well, we appreciate your time today. That's Executive Director of the Wisconsin Government Accountability Board, Kevin Kennedy, coming to us today from Minneapolis. Thanks very much for your time.
You're very welcome.
Who is interested in running against Governor Walker in the increasingly likely recall election? I'll be asking former Dane County Executive Kathleen Falk if she'll be a candidate. That's next on Upfront. And later, Wisconsin's economy and the outlook for 2012.
Upfront with Mike Goucher, brought to you by American Transmission Company and the Wisconsin Corn Growers Association.